My name is Martyn Dawes. I'm the founder and ex-CEO of Coffee Nation. So I started Coffee Nation in 1996. It was instant tabletop coffee dispensers selling a hot beverage to take away. I call it a cappuccino, but it was made with instant coffee. Sold for 49 pence. The trouble was it didn't work very well. Perhaps only 50, maybe 100 people at best per week were buying my coffee to take away. So I needed to find out what the answer was, how this was going to work. I knew I was onto something because people were buying it, but just not enough to make it a viable business. And then one day I was in one of the locations where we had a machine, and a customer said to me, if you want me to buy a product, a coffee to take away from this kind of location, it was a garage forecourt, and it's got to really wow me, it's got to knock me over, it's got to be a fantastic product. And in that moment I realised, it was my eureka moment, and I realised that what I needed to be selling instead was rather than an imitation, it needed to be the real thing. So a true gourmet cup of coffee, made with fresh beans, ground for that cup, with fresh milk. So I went back to the drawing board and replaced some of those instant machines with a real espresso machine. The Coffee Nation name appeared, the drink price went up by 50%, and the sales doubled, quadrupled in fact, overnight, and very quickly I was selling perhaps 800-900 cups per location per month. And I knew that I'd nailed it then, I was onto something. And basically I was creating a new category, unmanned, completely self-serve, but being able to put that coffee bar product into convenience stores and petrol forecourts. The timing was good, this was the late 90s. At that time, gourmet coffee was taking off in the UK. You could pick up a newspaper pretty much every day, there was an article about skinny lattes or drink through lids or coffee bar chains popping up around the UK. So at the end of 98, I was able to raise some seed capital, £100,000, and a small firm's loan. And then by 2000, we raised some private equity funding, and we got contracts with motorway service area operators, Rock and Brake, Texaco. We then landed a contract with Tesco in 2003, and the company grew very quickly. It became a new part of people's everyday routine, so much so that by 2006, 2007, people were actually going out of their way to find a Coffee Nation location.